Hey, Daddy, I want a golden goose.
Here we go again.
All right, sweetheart, all right. Daddy will get you a golden goose as soon as we get home.
No, I want one of those.
Bunker, how much do you want for the golden goose?
They're not for sale.
Name your price.
She can't have one.
Who says I can't?
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. Listen to this. I mean, you want to know other things that are going on that are so much more important. Here's something more important that nobody knows about. Just reported. What is today? May 11th? This is reported May 11th. So, in other words, it was just reported by College Fix, which is an extremely important website. Black student group at UC Santa Cruz threatens more campus takeovers if additional demands are not met. University of California, you know, UC Santa Cruz, the UC system is very, you know, it's the elite of state universities, right? It's been brought down by the leadership, the deans, the presidents. They're either leftist wimps or non-ideological wimps. Do you have that actually? Do you have a recording of that? When you can find that, it was one of the great questions posed yesterday. Listen to this. University of California Santa Cruz administrators recently agreed to meet all four demands lodged by a black student group who commandeered a campus building and would not leave until their conditions were met. By the way, I'll tell you the conditions in a moment. I was just thinking, though, what if a group of non-black students, or even a group including some black students, commandeered the dean's office, the president's office, right? And demanded that the students study Western civilization, that there be a required course in the history of Western civilization, that there be a required course titled Who Abolished Slavery? A required course, who in the 20, what country in the 20th century saved more people from tyranny than any other? All right? What if a group of kids came and took over the offices and demanded that, which has no race base, has nothing to do with race? The police would be called and they would be cleared out. That's what would happen. But black students came with left-wing demands. Woo. In addition to the four initial demands, the group has made three other demands to the university and has warned UC Santa Cruz that it has 4 months to comply with these demands or, quote, more reclamations will result. Now, a reclamation comes from the word reclaim. So did they once own the universities? Apparently so. Wherever whites are is occupied territory. After 3 days of occupation by students of Kerr Hall, Chancellor George Blumenthal agreed to give all black and Caribbean identified students a 4-year housing guarantee to live in the Rosa Parks African American themed house. Bring back the building's lounge, paint its exterior the Pan-African colors. This is their quote, of red, green, and black, and force all new incoming students to go through a mandatory diversity competency training. And, of course, he said yes to all of these demands. I think it should be illegal. It's a public university. I think it should be sued for having race-based dorms. A race-based dorm is racist. I don't care what race it is. That's just the way it is. That's the definition of racism. Or it's a manifestation of the definition of racism. Or it is a reclamation of the definition of racism. The student demonstrators raised a number of issues with campus leaders. This is what the Blumenthal, what is he, chancellor? Oh, it's so painful. Chancellor. He sounds like a nothing. The student demonstrators raised a number of issues with campus leaders. Issues we fundamentally agree upon, Blumenthal stated in a memo to the campus community announcing the concessions. Students from historically underrepresented communities deal with real challenges on campus and in the community. These difficulties include things that many people take for granted, such as finding housing or even just a sense of community. I don't get that. So people who are members of historically underrepresented communities have difficulties with finding housing? Why? Why would anybody find a difficulty in finding housing? A UC Santa Cruz student is one of the luckiest human beings on the face of the earth. Yet the African Black Student Alliance also demanded three additional provisions from UC Santa Cruz within its initial reclamation statement posted on the website of the African Black Coalition. African is spelled with a K. The group stipulated that if by fall quarter 2017, that's this fall, the university does not provide detailed plans on how it will fulfill its new demands, quote, there will be more reclamations. All right, now, let's see here. It's too bad. 1 minute. There's something wrong with their website, so they have an ad right in the middle of the thing that can't be removed. I have to read this to you, though. This is what is going on in America. This is the reason that fighting the left means preserving America. These black students are the product of leftism. They're oppressed, etc. I fixed it. I'll be able to read it to you when we come back. Yep, and there's a very bad kicker at the end. Stay tuned. I want to tell you something very important so you'll understand the big picture. I'm the big picture guy. I always look at the forest. What's the big picture? The big picture here is this. What the left does is, because they control the media, they control the narrative of the society. That's obvious. So what is really significant, namely the left-wing destruction of the society, is never reported. Did you know that black students had taken over another administrator office at a university? Did you know that? I didn't. Is that on CBS, NBC, ABC? You think it is worthy? Of course it's worthy. The demands that they're making for all black dormitories to be painted in the colors of the Pan-African movement, red, green, and black. All new coming students will have to go through a propaganda course called Diversity Competency Training. It's not worthy of a report on the news, this takeover of the university by radicals who loathe this society. Nah, it's not reported. Instead, this could be Trump's Watergate because of all the things that happen with regard to Russia and the elections. And they're smart. That's what the left does. It's like termites. They gnaw at the foundations of your house, but they somehow make a lot of noise in the attic. So you have no idea that the foundations are being eaten away. The alliance's three additional demands are that the university purchase a property to serve as a low-income housing cooperative for historically disadvantaged students, that the university allocate $100,000 for Santa Cruz's SOMCA, Student Organization Support Department, don't know what that is, S-O-M, small e, in other words, capital S-O-M, small e, capital C-A, and that the university create either a black studies department or a black studies minor or major. The group promised that if their demands are not met, UC Santa Cruz will, quote, force them to have to take what they know to be in their best interest to reclaim. The alliance's list of demands concludes with a quote from Asata Shakur, a former member of the Black Panther Party and a convicted murderer. There's a role model for you. Quote, it is our duty to fight for our freedom. It is our duty to win. We must love each other and support each other. We have nothing to lose but our chains. There you go. Did you know that black students at Santa Cruz are in chains? What do you think of that? You know what it is? It's an insult to those who are in chains. That's what it is. It's a complete insult to their slave ancestors. They didn't have freedom. They were in chains. For you to appropriate that fact is despicable. Blumenthal, that's the chancellor, in his memo, the campus community had denounced taking over buildings as a means of protest, saying it displaced the campus community, whatever the God's earth that means. Meanwhile, these kids take over his offices. Well, how you doing? Can I get you some Danish? The spokesman for UC Santa Cruz did not respond to a question on whether there will be any disciplinary action against the students who forcibly took over Kerr Hall. He only told The Fix, that's this website that's great about universities, that, quote, safety is the school's top priority. Safety, folks. No, I don't think safety should be the school's top priority. Anyway, the safety of the school was broken by violently taking over offices. Why isn't that a safety issue? Safety is an issue. It's not the top priority. Finally, as for the student demonstrators, they reject the term occupation to describe their reclamation actions, claiming, quote, we are pushing back against the language of occupation in recognition of the largely white-centric and fairly recent Occupy movement. They don't like the Occupy movement because it was white-centric. We are pushing back against the language of occupation in recognition of the very real settler occupations that are historical and ongoing, such as the European colonization and occupation of the Americas, as well as the current context of occupation in Palestine. There's always an anti-Israel end to these black radical and female or feminist radical. That's what unites them. If you hate Israel, you're one of us.